I need to get out of London.
I think a nice day out would do us all the world of good. Ernest, you must come
to... I don't think Blue's talking about a picnic.
I'm talking about leaving for good. I'm talking about going somewhere quiet and decent and trying to think for once.
A.A. Milne was very traumatised from the awful horrors of World War I, and it was part of his recovery to go into the innocence of the woods.
He bought the house on the edge of Ashdown Forest, which becomes the background of the Pooh books.
It was a great thrill to go to the forest and go to Pooh Bridge and imagine these are the places that a family played, and it initiated this extraordinary phenomenon that has charmed families and children all over the world.
That's a credit to Simon that he was able to swing it, that we could shoot in the Hundred Acre Wood. And I think it was important because it is very much about a specific place, you know, and you can't really fake it.
We're going backstage, as it were, and showing the lovely English life that people are nostalgic for.
We had beautiful days where we filmed the woods. We ended up with a green summer look that we didn't think we'd have. It's just beautiful.
As soon as you put our characters in their costumes with those magical toys in the real forest, it immediately captures an atmosphere.
Ready?
Yeah, same height, please.
Go.
We filmed the real Pooh Bridge, and it's quite hard to find. It's not over signposted, but there's people there every day from all over the world throwing sticks in.
That was really fun. It brought quite a few memories back as well, because I did Pooh Sticks for quite a while and I really loved it.
Me, I won.
Again?
Yes.
One of the things that Will was fantastic at was playing, and really playing. So it wasn't Will playing, it was Christopher Robin playing. And you ever gave him the toys, he'd really talk to them and feed them, or with the balloons, or when he knocks on Al's door. It was always a joy to watch.
You can sort of see, as Milne is playing this child in the film, you can see his mind working and thinking, gosh, this would make a good story.
Christopher Robin is up the tree, and you see Alan and Ernest looking at him in amazement, and you almost see that's the moment Winnie the Pooh is created.
It's a little world. Like you said, a 100-acre paradise.